الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على خير المرسلين خاتم النبيين ورحمة للعالمين وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي اللهم اجعلنا دعاة إليك وإلى رسولك أما بعد فقد قال الله تعالى في كتابه الكريم أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات طوبى لهم وحسن مآب وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم طوبى لمن رآني وآمنا بي ثم توبى لمن آمن بي ولم يراني صدق الله العلي العظيم وصدق رسول الكريم ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين ومن الشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين Indeed all praises are for Allah And we praise Allah and we glorify Allah and we testify to the oneness of Allah. Allah is a Rabb, Allah is the Lord, Allah is Al-Khaliq, Allah is the Creator. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Ar-Rahman, Allah is Ar-Rahim. Allah is most gracious, most compassionate, most kind and merciful, Al-Kareem. Allah is the most generous, Allah is Al-Ghafoor, Allah is the Forgiver. Allah is Al-Wadud, Allah is the lover, Allah is Al-Ghani, Allah is the rich one, Allah is Al-Aziz, Allah is the mighty one. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent his Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Allah has made him the seal of the prophets. Allah has made him rahmat, a mercy to the entire world. He is Al-Adl, he is the just one, he is As-Sadiq, the truthful Al-Amin. The most trustworthy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala together with him, Allah has revealed a book which is known as the Quran. A book, such a book, la rayba fi, in which there is no doubt whatsoever. Allah has sent with him hidayah. Allah has sent with him guidance. Huda, deenul haq. Allah has sent the way of truth, the only way that he accepts, al-Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has favored this ummah. Allah has favored this ummah with the title of being called Muslimin and Muslimat. It is Allah who has chosen this title for this ummah. My dear brothers, my dear sisters, if we were to count the favors of Allah, we will never ever be able to do so. This time is very precious. Yawmul Jum'ah, in the month of Dhul-Hijjah, the month which is coming to an end, the month which is closing the doors of Rahmat upon us. But beginning with a new year, a new month, a month which is also a sacred month in the Islamic calendar, the month which is known as Muharram. My dear brothers, my dear sisters, it is a good time. Not that any other time before this time is not a good time. Every time is a good time. But today is such an auspicious day. It is such a blessed day. It is such a special moment. And this time is also a very special time. It is a time we need to look at ourselves in the mirror. Look at ourselves in the mirror of the Akhirat and see what it is that we have done for our Akhirah. See what it is that we have prepared for our hereafter. See what it is that we have sent for our lives ahead. See what contributions we have made towards that world. What sum of money we have invested in that bank account. What sort of deeds have we sent there? It is very, very important, my dear brothers, my dear sisters, that we take some time out and we contemplate and we make fikr, we worry and we concern in regards to what we have done with this life that Allah has given to us, with this health that Allah has given to us, with the little wealth that Allah has given to us, with the iman that Allah has given to us, let us ask ourselves, make fikr, make worry, make concern in regards to what is it that we have done with all these bounties, all these ni'mat, all these favors that Allah has given to us in regards to our akhirat and our hereafter. Look at the world and we will realize and we will recognize. We don't have to sit and ponder because our minds are always clicking. What is it I have to do today? What is it I have to do next moment? Who is it I have to meet? What business transaction I have to involve myself in? What deals I have to cut? Our minds are always ticking. How is it I can do this better to get more? How is it I can do that better to get more? Our minds are always working in regards to building our hereafter, building our dunya, building this world, building our homes in this world. Building our homes in this world, we take it as the focus of our lives because we don't see what is waiting for us in the hereafter. Very, very important for us to understand, my dear brothers, my dear sisters, if we were to look in the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what did he mention to us? Pay attention and understand it well. Let it go through one ear and come down into our hearts. Let us make worry and fikr about it. Let us make sure that we concern ourselves about this hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ponder over the words. He says to his sahabas, many ummats in the past, Allah had given them long lives, many, many years of livelihood. Nuh alayhi salam, he dwelt with his people, he preached to his people 950 years, the hadith states. That is only what he preached to his people. That wasn't his age. So we can imagine how old he was. How long he lived. Adam alayhi salam, subhanallah. Musa alayhi salam, they lived many, many years. Thousands of years. He says, but my ummah, the average age of a muqtadi, the average age of an ummati, of my ummah is between 60 and 70. Between what? 60 and 70. If you go beyond that, alhamdulillah. But that's the average age. Now let's ask ourselves, how far away are we from that? If we know that one day in the akhirat, one day, subhanallah, Allah says, one day in the hereafter, it's Kamsina Al-Fasana. What's Kamsina Al-Fasana? 50,000 years. 50,000 years. One day in the year after. The age of my ummati, 60 to 70. How much labor, how much have we been toiling, how much have we been working, focusing on bettering, making our dunya better and better and better. And what is it that we are doing for our hereafter to make it better? It's a very important question. Even before our hereafter, even before our hereafter, imtihan upon imtihan, we are making preparations, examinations upon examinations, this exam, that exam, you name it. Children today, when they go to school, 10, 15, 18 subjects children do in school. Subhanallah. You think about it. And they find time for all of that. We make sure that we find time to sit with them or send them for lessons. How much time is spent? How much time is spent behind the education of our children? How much time is spent in preparing our children for the life in the qabr? How much time? What is the investment that we are making in regards to our children? Because our children, they are our legacy. Our children, they are the ones that when we leave and we leave them behind, if we don't teach them proper, they won't even know to make a dua for us. Our children, they will carry our names either in a good way or in a bad way. If we don't inculcate this deen into the lives of our children, this legacy of the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which we supposed to invest in our kids in regards to deen, in regards to qabr, in regards to akhirat, then my dear brothers, my dear sisters, no amount of degree, no amount of BA and MBA and whatever will be able to gain us salvation in the hereafter. This is the investment of the Ummah. Today we have pursued the dunya so much in regards to educating our kids that even the very said kids, because we have failed Islamically to raise them and teach them the value of a child in Islam. Who is a child in Islam? The deen of the child, the iman of the child. Create the environment of iman for that child. Because we have failed to do that, academically, our children, they have turned against us. No child, no 1 year, 2 year, or 3 year child says, "Daddy, I want to see cartoons today and you have to put on TV for me." We create an environment of cartoons for our children because it acts now as a babysitter. What they look at, we have created that environment. Why do I say that? Because the words of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells us that every single child is born upon the fitrah. What is the fitrah? The fitrah, it's a natural inclination towards Allah and this way of Allah. That is fitrah. A natural inclination. The child, they are naturally inclined towards Allah's deen. That Allah is one. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the final messenger. The way of Islam. But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, you, the parents, the father, the mother, it is they who guide the child now either to become a Yahud or a Christian or a Majus. Subhanallah. It is either we who direct the course of our children's life to be away from the path of Al-Islam, or we direct it towards being an iman dadwala, as we will say, a person with iman. We are building the future of our children. But what kind of future are we building? It's a question we need to ask ourselves. What is it that is going to save them in the qabr? What is it that is going to save them in the hereafter? Is it all the degrees? No. It is the deen that we would have taught them, the deen. Anything comes second to deen is sure lost. Anything comes second to deen, my dear brothers, my dear sisters, it has to be deen, deen, and deen. Because everything in dunya is based on deen. Everything in the dunya, whether it be our transactions, it has to be based on our deen. What is deen? Deen is iman. Iman. How we conduct transaction, if there is no iman in that transaction, it's a failure. How we deal with our salat, if there is no iman in that salat, Allah doesn't want it. How we give our charity, if there is no iman in that, Allah doesn't want it. How we raise our children, if there is no iman in that, Allah doesn't want it. It doesn't last. Iman. My dear brothers, my dear sisters, we need to take time off. Look at the mirror of the akhirat and let us see. Let us see the reflection of our hereafter. What is it that we have sent forth? What is it we have sent forth? Who can safely say that when I die, my son or my daughter is going to read some Quran for me? If we didn't teach them. If we didn't teach them. Subhanallah. What are they going to do for us? What are they going to do for themselves in their cupboard, in their graves, when they don't know anything about deen? When they didn't learn anything about Islam, when they didn't learn how to read the Quran, when they didn't learn about Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when they didn't even know who is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what is his rights upon us? What is it we have to do as believers? Subhanallah. Then we would have lost we would have failed our children. We would have failed our children, given them all the luxuries in life, given them all the niceties of life, given them all the things that they ask for in life, beside Islam, we give and we give and we give, but when it comes to Islam, we compromise it with them. We compromise it with them. Subhanallah. I heard about a couple in Germany who had accepted Islam. Subhanallah. A little child, 3 years old they had. Such an environment they created for this child. At morning time, the child don't want to take a bath. The mother has to scold the child. What does the mother say to the child? What does the mother say to the child? If you don't bathe, I'm going to make you an engineer and a doctor when you get big. Do you understand that? If you don't bathe, I'm going to make you an engineer or a doctor when you get big. What do you think the child do? The child will want to bathe now. Because why? The value of being an alim and a hafiz, it was built in that environment that the child understood. The first thing that I have to be is a hafiz of the Quran or alim of the Quran. An alim in this deed. Because this is what gives honor and dignity. They looked at the doctors and the engineers and the lawyers second to the deen of Allah. Second to the deen of Allah. You know, you say like, if you don't behave yourself, I'm going to carry it by that person. And that person in the child's mind is what? That is a bad person. Yeah, I'm going to put you in the ants patch. That is a bad thing. So the doctor and the engineer, in the mind of this child, that is a bad thing. Subhanallah. What is the good thing? Learning about Allah's deen. Learning about Allah's book. This was the environment that these people created. Reverts into Islam. Subhanallah. Today, we create all different kinds of environment for our children, except a deeny environment. Our children will go to school. They will come home in the evening. At evening time, they will go to lessons. When they return, a little bit of time we have to spend with them. That is the time we find sitting behind the television. No family getting together. No family talk. Either they're behind their laptop, internet, whatever. No environment of deen is created. None whatsoever. But then we expect that when we die, our children will do X, Y, and Z for us. Our children don't even know for their own selves. What is it I have to do for mommy when she passes away? What is it I have to do for my father when he passes away? What is it I have to do for myself? I can't even perform a salah. I don't know the correct way to perform a salah. I do it as I see people doing it. My dear brothers, my dear sisters, this is the time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, through His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, He tells us in the hadith, subhanallah, that you and me, we were born upon the fitrah, the natural part, natural inclination to this deen of Allah. Every single child was born like that. Then let's ask ourselves now, where are our children? Today we are running to find help for our children. Today we have to find help for our children from all sorts of different people, different walks of life. We can't get them under control. We can't get them to perform a salah. So bad it has gotten that our children have gone to disobey us so much, we have to shut our mouths and stay quiet. Because you know why? We are afraid. If you only correct them, they're going to move in a different direction. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, when a child reaches 7, spank them, teach them to pray. If they reach 10 and they are not praying, beat them. Who was him? Who was the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? A mercy to the world. Why is he saying this? Beat them if they don't pray at the age of 10. So much mercy he had. But today, we watch them sleep and we say, oh God, I feel so hard to wake them up. feel so hard to wake them up. I feel so hard to bring them in the mosque to perform a salat. And this is how, when they get bigger, when they get older, they will start to pray. Right now, they're concentrating on their academics. They have to excel in school. Every single salat that they miss, it falls on our shoulders as parents. It falls on our shoulders. Allah is going to take us to task for that. Subhanallah. The words of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam are the words of truth. Our legacy is in our children. We have to groom them, we have to train them, we have to teach them. Let us not fail in this. Let us not fail in this. And the first and foremost thing we have to put into their lives is what is known as Islam, Iman, Taqwa. This deen, this way of life has to be the first and foremost thing. Everything must fall under the way of life, which is known as Islam. Every single aspect of dunya must fall under Islam. If it's not there, my dear brothers, my dear sisters, there is no success in that. None whatsoever. Look at the people of the past. Ali radiallahu ta'ala, he used to say to his children, Hassan and Hussein, as a matter of fact, in his last will that he had written to his two sons, who were his two sons, in the very early part of their lives, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam had already mentioned Hassan and Hussein. Who are they? Sayyida Shababi Ahlil Jannah. They are the two youngsters of Jannah. The chief of all the youngsters. Where? In Jannah. Ali radiallahu ta'ala, he wrote in his will for his two sons, Hassan and Hussein radiallahu ta'ala. He says, oh my sons, he says, let not this dunya deceive you in regards to your akhirah. Who is he sending this for? Hassan and Hussein. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has already promised them what? Jannat, paradise. Still Ali is saying to them what? In his will, let not this dunya deceive you in regards to hereafter. Oh my sons, he wrote in his will, frequently visit the Qabristan. Let the cemetery always be a place that you visit often. Why? Because in there you will see the ruins of those great, great personalities that had walked on the face of the earth with pomp and show, who had it all, who ruled. Look at their lofty palaces. Look at their places of dwelling. Look at whatever they have and see where their body lies today. You too will have to go there, oh my sons. Ali radiallahu ta'ala instructed his sons like that. Yaqub alayhi salam instructed his sons also. In the Quran it is mentioned, Am kuntum shuhada idh hadara Yaqub al-maut. Were you present there? Were you witnesses? When death approached Yaqub alayhi salatu wasalam, idh qala libani, when he said to his children, Ma ta'buduna min ba'di, what is it you're going to worship after I leave here? What is it? Who is it you're going to worship after my passing away? What was their response? Na'budu ilahaka wa ilaha abaika Ibrahim wa Ismail wa Ishaq. We will worship your God. We will worship the God that you pray to. The God of Ibrahim alayhi salam, Ismail alayhi salam, Ishaq alayhi salam. Who is that? Ilahan wahida, one true God. Wa nahnu lahu muslimun. And we will be from amongst those who submit. In his last pangs of life, his last moments of life, what was his worry? What was his fikr? What was his concern? Are you going to hold on to this deen? He taught his children about it. What will be our concern in the last moment of our lives? How much this one have to get? How much that one have to get? who should get the house, who should get the business, who should get the car. Look at the fork, look at the difference. My dear brothers, my dear sisters, if we don't set the pace now, tomorrow on the day of judgment, we will be very, very sad. Tomorrow on the day of judgment, we will come out as losers. Let us understand it very well. We have a duty to fulfill. Time is going. Time is running away. Today is a very, very important day for us to make some introspection. Look at our lives. Look in the mirror of the hereafter and see what is it that we have done for our hereafter. What is it that we have given to our children for their hereafter, for the life in the cupboard, and for when we stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when Allah revealed the ayat of the Quran, Alladhina amanu wa amilu salihat. The two things that are needed for a very beautiful place in the hereafter. Subhanallah, iman, the first, righteous deeds. You don't just have iman and don't do anything. And you don't just do good deeds and you don't have iman. Hand in hand, iman, righteous deeds. Certainly those who have iman and they do righteous deeds. Allah says, Tuba lahum, good fortune for them, happiness for them, all kinds of joys for them. Wa husnu ma'ab. What a beautiful return that is. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Tuba liman ra'ani wa amana bi. He says, Tuba, good fortune, happiness and joy for that person who saw me and he brought iman in me, he believed in me. Good fortune for that person, happiness for that person, joy for that person. Where? In Jannah. Then he says, wa tuba thumma tuba thumma tuba liman amana bi wa lam yarani. Three times he says it. Good fortune, good fortune, good fortune for that one who brought iman in me and he did not even see me. Subhanallah. Have we ever seen the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? In another narration, this word tuba, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, what is this? Shajaratun fil jannah. It is a tree in paradise. Tuba, it's a tree in paradise. Masiratuha miyatu amin. Subhanallah. The spread of this tree, the width of this tree is 100 years. 100 years. Thiyabun ahlul jannah. The people of Jannah, those people who will be dwelling in Jannah, they will get their clothing from this tree. Takruju min akmamiha. They will take it out from the bark of the tree. The clothes from Jannah. In another hadith it states, Inna fil Jannah shajaratun yasiru rakibu fi zilliha miyata amin la yaqta'uha. That certainly in paradise, there is a tree. It will take a rider with a very fast horse. It will take him 100 years. And still he will not come out from the shade of that tree. Subhanallah. Allah is saying for those who do good deeds, and they bring iman in Allah, and they do good deeds, then this is waiting for them in Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from amongst them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open our hearts, open our eyes. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfiq and the ability so that we will understand what are our duties. We will understand what is our purpose here. We will understand the responsibilities that we have in regards to our children, that they are our legacy that we will leave behind. We hope and pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will guide us and guide them. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open the doors of Jannah and grant us with this tree, which is known as Tuba, on the day of Qiyamah. Wal akhir da'wana, and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.